Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this session. My name is Komal Pal. I'm a senior product manager with AWS. And today I'm going to be talking to you about two recent innovations in RDS called optimized writes and optimized reads. Let's get started. To begin with, a brief introduction of RDS. So Amazon RDS is a managed relational database service with a choice of popular database engines, including open source engines like MySQL, MariaDB, Postgres, and also a couple of commercial engines like SQL Server and Oracle. So you might wonder why choose RDS? Because Amazon RDS removes the significant effort of managing and scaling your databases, allowing you to focus on making your customers successful. And we do that by making your databases easier to administer. You can easily deploy and maintain your hardware, your operating system, and database engine. We make your databases more available and durable by supporting options such as automatic multi-AZ data replication, automated backups and snapshots and failovers. We make your databases more performant and scalable by supporting scale compute and storage within just a few clicks with minimal downtime for your application. And finally, we make your databases more secure and compliant by supporting data encryption at rest and in transit. And we also assist customers with their compliance goals through tooling. With that, let's move to the two features that we're going to talk about today. That's Amazon RDS optimized writes and optimized reads. The first thing we're going to talk about today is Amazon RDS optimized writes. But before we get into optimized writes, let's talk about how writes happen in MySQL today. Now, there's no question today that when writing to a database, developers or DBAs will expect their database to protect their data. For MySQL users, today they can trust that their data is safely being written to the database because it writes that information twice. So how this works is that MySQL incrementally writes 16 kilobyte pages to the storage in 4 KB chunks. However, in case of a system failure, some of these chunks may not make it to the storage, which can cause data corruption. To protect themselves in a scenario like this, MySQL users can use a built-in storage engine feature, which is called the double write buffer. So in the event of a power outage or some other type of failure, users can still access an intact copy of their data from this buffer, even if the data written to the storage got corrupted. Now, while this will protect the user's data from data loss, but it does have some drawbacks. As you might imagine, it is slower. Writing data twice is going to take twice as long as a single write. It is also inefficient because it takes twice as much IOPS bandwidth, which reduces your database throughput as well as performance. And finally, it's expensive. For customers who have a high volume of concurrent transactions, they'll need to provision additional storage IOPS to meet their performance requirements. As a result of this, we wanted to provide customers with a more efficient way to safely write their data. And we introduced what's called Amazon RDS optimized writes. So optimized writes will protect customers from data loss without needing to write the data twice. That it works by ensuring that all of the data on your disk is aligned to 16 kilobyte pages on the NVMe storage. And these 16 kilobyte pages are written to the storage as a single atomic operation. Now, how this works is that to write the files to the table storage durably in one step, Optimized Writes uses a feature which was recently announced. It's called Torn Write Prevention, which is a new feature of the AWS Nitro system. Torn write prevention will ensure that the 16 KB data page in memory is safely written to the table storage in one single step and is protected from failures such as power loss during the writes. Now let's look at a high level how this works. So on your left is an instance without optimized writes, and on the right is a system with optimized writes. We discussed earlier how when standard MySQL receives a write, it goes straight to the in-memory buffer pool, and it's then written to a double write buffer in 16 kilobyte pages. And from that buffer, the data is then again written to your table space. So that's a total of two writes. However, on the right-hand side, on a system with optimized reads enabled, when a write comes through, it still goes to the in-memory buffer pool. But instead of writing to the double write buffer, it skips this step and safely writes directly to your table space, which ultimately results in an improvement in your transaction throughput by up to 2x. So using optimized writes, you are able to optimize provisioned storage by writing more transactions per second for the same level of provisioned IOPS. Optimized writes is available for customers deploying new RDS for MySQL databases using any supported instance type and MySQL version 8030 or higher in all the regions where the supported instance types are available. Now that we've talked about RDS, how RDS for MySQL users write to their databases and how we've improved that process, let's talk about accelerated query processing on RDS. And before we get into optimized reads, let's again talk about how reading on MySQL and MariaDB happen today. So ordinarily, when MySQL or MariaDB process complex queries, such as those that involve grouping or sorting, it will generate temporary objects. And when these objects don't fit into the memory, they are moved to the disk storage. In case of RDS, this means that the temporary objects get written to or read from the Amazon Elastic Block Store. So we wanted to explore how we could make this more performant. And hence we came up with Amazon RDS optimized reads, which provides up to 2x faster query processing for complex queries that utilize temporary tables. So these are queries such as those that involve sorts, hash aggregations, high load joins, and common table expressions or CTEs. Let's again look at how this works in practice. So on the left is an RDS MySQL instance without optimized reads, and on the right is an instance with optimized reads. So whenever you have a complex query, instead of placing the temporary table on Amazon Elastic Block Store, optimized reads will place your temporary table directly onto your database instance's local NVMe storage, which allows us to process your complex query up to 2x faster than before. And the great thing about optimized reads is that it's on by default for all new and existing RDS, MySQL, and MariaDB databases whenever you use a supported instance and version. To get started, you can deploy optimized reads on select Intel as well as Graviton-based instances today using either the RDS console or the API. It is available on both MySQL and MariaDB with specific versions that are listed on the screen in front of you. To get started, you simply go to the Amazon RDS console. You can create a database, choose RDS for MySQL or MariaDB, and launch your workload on any instance type that has a local instance store, such as an M6GD or R6GD. And from here, you can simply determine all of your other database specifications as usual and create the database. Your new database will automatically deploy with optimized reads. And if you want to enable optimized reads on an existing instance, all you have to do is move your workload to an optimized read enabled instance. Finally, I encourage you to try out optimized writes and reads with your MySQL or MariaDB workload on Amazon RDS to see the performance improvements for yourself. A few resources to get you started with both of those features are listed on the screen in front of you and will also be shared in the chat. I'll stop here. I thank you for joining us in this session. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to address them now.